In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create BIPV facades in Revit. Essentially, these are solar panel integrated facades, and I'm going to be showing you how to create them in Revit with the help of a free plugin. We're going to show all of the steps and outline the entire workflow. Let's go! Now, before we get started, let's first talk about BIPV, or Building Integrated Photovoltaics. These are photovoltaic materials that are used to replace conventional building materials in parts of the building envelope, such as the roof, skylight, or facades. They are increasingly being incorporated into the construction of new buildings as a principal or ancillary source of electrical power, although existing buildings may be retrofitted with similar technology. BIPV World is an independent online platform created for architects and construction experts, offering advanced BIM design tools that improve collaboration, streamline information sharing, and promote innovation in BIPV projects and technologies. This platform provides detailed insight into the economic impact of design decisions, including cost analysis, potential yield, and ROI. With a progressive, first-time-right design philosophy that combines simplicity with structural integrity, BIPV World boasts an extensive catalog of over 1 million different BIPV products. Now, if you would like to check out this platform, it's absolutely free and you can follow along with this video. I'm going to be leaving a link to it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. And now, without any further ado, let's jump straight to the BIPV World platform. And here we are on the BIPV World platform. So here you can explore this page. You can see you have all of the products and services, BIPV Architect, so on and so forth. And you can just take a look at and explore what's available here. Now, the first step is going to be to register. So if I click here on register, here you can fill out your company name, website, and all of the basic information to register the account. And once you have the account, you just simply log in. Now, I'm just going to escape out of here because I'm already logged into my account. You can see this is what that looks like. You get this whole dashboard where it's going to display all of your information, your projects, and so on. Now, the next option here is projects. I don't have any created right now. We're just going to be doing that in a moment. But I first want to show you the downloads page. Now, this is the most important one, at least for us when we're getting started, because we, well, want to download the plugin. So you can see here we have the Revit plugin. You can click here to download it. You install it. It's a basic process, so you can install that easily on your computer. We also have some tutorials and some other downloads that you can explore, but the main thing is to get the plugin. Now, let's go back to projects and let's create a new project. So let's go here to add, and then we have to add an internal number. So I'm just going to type that out. We also need the project name, which I'm just going to call warehouse. Then we need to add a short description. So this will be facade renovation and applicable item for this building. So in this case, this will be a renovation project. So I'm just going to add that. In this case, we have a warehouse. We want to renovate the facade, and we want to use a BIPV facade. Let's go to the project location. Now, in this case, I'm just going to pick Netherlands as the country because this is a kind of a test project. I don't really have a correct address, zip code, or city. However, for your projects, you are going to obviously have an address and a zip code and a city, and you do want to include that because it's going to use that information for the yield calculation, and that's really important. Moving forward, we can choose the BIPV type. I'm going to go with the ventilated facade. The wind zone is going to be wind zone 1. For the start date of this project, let's click here on the little calendar, and let's say I want to start this project 1st of September. And I'm hoping to finish the project by the end of November. And also for the expected date for the first kind of iteration of the design, I'm going to add that at, let's say, September the 25th, for example. And then we can also add a longer description of the project if we need to. In this case, I'm just going to leave that blank and then hit save. Now in the projects, it's going to show our warehouse project. We can also add an image if we want to use an image. In this case, I don't, so I'm just going to leave that blank. And also you can go and edit this at any point if you want to change something. Going back to the dashboard, you'll see that now here we have our project. I can click here on show project, so it's going to give me some project information. Here we also have the option to add files, so you can add your Revit project file. Here I have that warehouse project file, so I'm just going to hit open and upload that. Now we don't really have to upload the Revit file at this stage, however I just want to show you that yeah, we can include that, and we can also include other files for this project. So any other documentation or other file types, you can upload that here and have them all at one convenient place. Also here you can find designs and revisions, so you can have multiple designs and obviously revisions. So if you're working on a project and you have multiple ideas, well then you can provide the cost and yield indications for each of those designs, and you can create a more informed design decision for the project. And it's also really important to mention that here we have this stakeholders button, and if we open that up, here we have a list of all of the stakeholders. Obviously in this case this is a new project, so we haven't added anyone, but here we can add all of the stakeholders so they can have access to this project and all of the project information that's located here. Now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So this is our warehouse project. And now because we have installed the BIPV World plugin, it's going to appear over here as a tab. And then here we have some tools. So first I'm just going to jump into settings. So here we have all the settings. So now we know where the family library location is, and all of the kind of basic information. This is the project region that we've mentioned is really important. So we pretty much have all of the basics set up here. So I'm just going to leave this as is, or just hit save, and then let's exit out of that menu. Now it's also important to mention that the BIPV World plugin uses shared parameters, so you may need to have a file for that. So I'm just going to include a link to a video how to do that down in the comment section below the video, so you can check it out there. Now let's do the actual fun part, which is to turn this facade into a BIPV facade. So let's go here to select faces. Here we need to select the revision, so I'm just going to select this one, hit apply, and that's going to open up this window. So here what you'll notice is we have a list of all of the walls included in this project where we can host our facade. And now we can select the wall that we want to apply a facade to, a BIPV facade to, here in the list. Now this is really convenient because it gives you the orientation. And then another option is to just go here to Revit. So let me just orbit around, and then let's say I want to place a facade on this particular wall. Now I'm just going to bring that menu back up and click here on the Revit button. So it's just going to check the wall that I have selected in Revit. So it's this one. So for the next step, we can click here on 2D wall. And what this will do is it's going to create a 2D view showing us our wall where we're going to be creating this facade. So let's bring this menu back up. And now the next step is just to click here to start the process of applying the BIPV facade. Now this menu allows us to first pick the panel that we want to use. So our main solar panel is going to be, let's see, I'm going to pick this one, the matte black Solar Pro Design 96. And yeah, let's choose that one. And then we need another one for kind of the borders and edges. So this is a passive panel, so not an active one that's going to be actually giving us electricity. So this is just a passive panel, so let's choose that one. And for each of these, you do have a range in terms of the sizes that are available, and then you can adjust accordingly and pick whatever works for you within that range. In this case, I'm happy with the current settings, so I'm just going to go to set a grid automatically. And when I click on automatic grid, you can see that it basically created a layout. Now this is going to feel a bit similar to the curtain walls in Revit, however it just does a more advanced thing. And now when we finally hit run, it's going to start applying the panels that we have selected on this wall. And once we're done, it's going to look like this. So let's close out of this menu. Let's click here. And this is basically what we get. If I go to the 3D view here, you can see we have those main active panels, and then we have the passive panels on the side. Now you can select each one of those. And yeah, as you can see, they're a family, and you can see all of the parameters for that. Now, something else that you may want to see is what's happening behind this. So if I select one of these panels, right click, select all instances in the entire project, like that. And now let's just temporarily hide these elements. You can see that below this, we have those mounting elements. So everything is there, very detailed, very nice. So let's now bring back those active panels, and now let's actually isolate those. So I'm just going to select all instances in the project. And now if I isolate this element, what you'll notice is if we orbit behind, you can see that it's not just the panel, but we also have the connector and all of the elements there. So it's actually fairly detailed. And now we can just reset everything back up. And yeah, so we have the border panels, the passive panels, and then here we have the main active panels. Now we're going to be moving on to the next facade. In this case, that's going to be this one. And let's open that menu back up. Click here on Revit. So that's going to be this one. So what we're going to be doing for this one is we're going to be making a few changes. So let's go first to the wall, and then let's click on the little hashtag icon here to start the process of applying panels. So for the main panel, I'm going to go with something different. And I'm just going to pick a gray panel in this case. So let's search for that. So yeah, we have the Solar Pro Design 96 gray. So I want to choose that one. And then for our passive panels, I'm just going to choose this one. Now in this case, instead of having just a regular set of panels or a regular grid arrangement, I want to do something a bit more interesting. I want to add a small row of inactive or passive panels in between the main ones, so I can give the main ones a bit of a tilt. So here I'm just going to type in 2,395 for the vertical grid size, PV plus passive. And then here we can add the depth or Z difference. So I'm just going to go with 130. And then let's go with automatic grid. So once I apply that, you're going to see a grid pop up here. And as you can see, we have those main panels, and then we have the passive panels in between. Now, once I hit run, it's going to generate that. And now I'm just going to close this menu, and let's go to the 3D view. And this is what we have. As you can see here, we have that tilt of the main panel, so it can be more efficient at absorbing sunlight. And then we have this row of smaller passive panels. And again, it looks really, really good. Now, of course, we can always switch this to realistic and then see everything a bit nicer. There we go. So we have those panels there. Now let's move forward to the final wall that we have left here for this facade, which is going to be this one. So I'm just going to select it like that, and then let's bring this menu back up. Again, I'm just going to click on Revit. So it's this one. Let's uncheck this one. So this is the one. Then I can click here to surface selection, and it's going to generate that elevation view here. And now let's click on the hashtag button to get us started. Now here I'm going to be using a bit of a different approach. So we're not going to be using the automatic grid at first, but before we go into that, let's actually select the panels. So here I'm going to select first the panels, and in this case I'm not going to go with the ones we've used. I'm going to find something a bit different. So I want to use one of these landscape panels. So let's use this one, the chameleon panel, and let's choose it. And then for color, as you can see, it's RGB, so we can pick out a color or print, which is nice. And then again, let's pick out just a regular passive panel. And now I'm just going to go here to select grid manually. And what this will do is it's going to allow us to pick that grid. Now here, as you can see, we have our wall, but we also have these lines here. So if you select this line and pull it down, as you can see, it's a red line, and it's basically a crop or a boundary of your facade. So we should be able to pick out the bottom one. Here it is. There we go. So we can say, okay, I want my facade to be here within this boundary. So we can just set that boundary up and then go back to this menu. And here, let's now click on automatic grid. So it's going to generate a grid within that. Now at any point we can continue making changes. So if I want to move this up a little bit, just like that. So here, as you can see, I've accidentally moved this line. So not the red boundary, but this inner grid. So I'm just going to go back, and then I'm going to select it again, and let's just hide it. Okay, so this is the wall shape, so I can move it up here. That's okay. I can unjoin these elements. Okay, so there we go. So now we have some elements outside of this. That's okay. We can go back to our menu, and then we can go to automatic grid, and it's just going to give us a little warning, and we can say, yes, I do want to update this. I didn't make a mistake. I genuinely want to make an update. And now this is what we get. So once I'm happy with the actual design, I can then simply hit run. And once it's done, here we go, we have it. And if we go to the 3D view, this is what that looks like. So it's different than the previous ones because we only have a specific region which we have defined, and we only show the panels there, or we have only applied the panels there, which is exactly what we wanted. So there we go. We now have three facades or three walls with the BIPV facade applied. And now what we could do as a next step would be to go to export to portal, and this is going to allow us to get a price estimate for this project. So within just 10 minutes you can generate or complete a BIPV facade for your project. You're going to have everything in Revit looking exactly how it should. You can have different facades or different styles for each of the walls, and then you can export that to portal, get the pricing, and go from there. I hope you have enjoyed this video. As I said, if you want to test out BIPV world for yourself, I'm going to be including a link to that up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video.